Good morning. It's around 8:40 in the morning, and I had a great sleep last night. Pretty much rained off and on all night. It's raining now. I got up at 8, or maybe a little bit before 8, and just kind of been waiting for a break in the rain to cook breakfast. And we're going to be doing that breakfast that we bought in Bala at Jack and Stella's. It's called the Eggy Explosion. And so that's all the ingredients I bought yesterday. The only thing, I was kind of hoping that maybe this park had one of those, you know, kind of picnic areas where it had like a roof over it, and I could have just drove over there and just set up in the dryness of that kind of an eating shelter. Again, I wasn't planning on doing this park. I was thinking I was going to be going back up to North Bay and doing those restaurants, so I didn't think of bringing extra camping type things like tarps and ropes and so this was kind of an unplanned last minute thing, but yeah, we'll make it work. What I'm thinking about doing is opening up the hatch of the van and just setting up there, and that will keep me somewhat dry. I guess I will get up, get changed, get dressed, and we'll give it a shot. We'll do our best. Yeah, it's just raining a little bit. We'll open up the hatch. I think we'll be able to manage. Again, nobody around. Great time to go camping. Middle of September, middle of the week. So again, I've had this on since yesterday when you saw me plug it in. And now the 1500 is down to 16%. Again, that will get me all the way home. It's saying I got 3.5 hours left of power plugged into that. The other Jackery is still full pretty much. Didn't use much of that at all. I think number one thing is to get coffee ready. We're gonna try this out for the first time on a camping trip. Medium roast Starbucks instant coffee. Got to get some more water. Tap it right here. It's 10 degrees Celsius, so kind of cold. It's fine in my van, but it's getting cooler out here. I do have my rain jacket, it starts to get a little more wet out here. At Pike Place. My brother-in-law hooked me on these when we're up at the cottage. If nobody wants to make a big pot of coffee. Cheers and good morning. Nothing like a nice hot cup of coffee. Camping out of the back of your minivan. Hanging out with you guys. I'm gonna enjoy this for a couple of minutes, and then we'll get out the bacon and we'll cook up a few pieces of bacon first on the cast iron. And then we'll slowly manufacture the eggy explosion. I believe that's what it's called. The only thing I'm missing is the tomato. I totally forgot about the tomato part. Oh well. Lots of dirt. Whoa. Sandy area. I use this little mini speaker system at nighttime. It's called Head Rush. And it stops my cell phone from using its battery on the mic. I mean, on the speakers. All right, let's open this up. Get out all of our stuff. Don't need the sausages. Definitely need the butter. Definitely need the bread. Eggs. Don't need chocolate. Don't need beer. Need that. Jeez. Again, this isn't the best setup. Still, people, I know. Eventually, we'll have a really good system happening. Just not today. Let's try and get everything close to the door so I don't have to keep climbing in. Ah, yeah. Yep. Bacon time. I'm going to get this going too. Fuel. Small pan, large bacon. It's going to be a mess. Just the way we like it. As it shrinks, it will give us more room. Also started a little garbage bag right here. Just hung it off my indicator switch. That's just come in handy. Keeps it open for me. Getting close. I want them crispy. This one can come off. There we go. I'm probably just gonna like wipe this out a little bit. Maybe put a little bit of butter in the bottom of it, and then we'll do our buns. I'm gonna do two, of course. Get our cheese ready. This was the only chipotle sauce that they sold, so I'm hoping it will do. It's a chipotle mayo. Yep, that'll do. Bacon's pretty much done. Gonna get that crunch. Gonna get the crunch. I'm feeling to knock that over. Okay, I'm gonna wipe this out. Get some of the grease out, but I need some of the grease. Not too much, that's all. So I gotta cut a hole in the middle of that. That will work. Put one there. Pop out number two. put that there. I figure before we do that, I think we're gonna put in just a bit of butter. I bought the butter for a reason. I really wanted to butter them up. Saturate both sides in the butter. Oh yeah, yeah, that's the way to do it, Ken. Yeah, oh yeah, that is gonna make it even tastier. Perfect. Oh, didn't make that hole big enough. All flowed out over top. Oh well. I'm gonna salt and pepper them now. All seasoned up. Oh yeah. That is a thing of beauty right there. I've got it on like a medium heat. So when I see it starting to cook up halfway through, I'll flip it over. Got my flipper, my oofer. Some people call it a spatula. I think flipping them right now would be a great idea. Let's give one a shot and see if it works. Yep. This is taking really long. Oh my goodness. That looks freaking awesome. Let's put the cheese on. Cheese on. One. And I'm guessing the only way to get that cheese really to melt if you put a lid on it. And while we're at it, let's put our bacon on. We've got some crispy, we've got some chewy. Chewy, punch it, Chewy. Oh, look at that, we have a bonus piece. Just for Kem. Well, they look ready. I'm going to move them to the table here. I'm gonna shut the stove off, just move the whole thing to the table. Put one there. And one there. Wow, eh? Look good? Yes, it does. Now that that's done, we've got to get our chipotle. And that's got to go all over the top. Again, the only thing I'm missing is tomato. I guess if you heated that up and made it more liquidy, it would just pour all over. But that looks kind of neat, I guess. Looks like a couple of small dogs had a little issue on top of my sandwiches. Let's eat. All right, guys. Another quick sip of coffee. Put that over there for a sec. I'm using my cutting board as my plate, making it easier. Just gonna smear this all over. There we go. I think I should have put the bacon under the cheese, but oh well. Let's cut in. And the egg is done. Nice. I was worried that it was going to be still gooey in the middle. The English muffin is crunchy, along with that bacon. And the butter definitely was an added bonus. And the fact that I got it all crispy on it, on the edge. Wow. And that chipotle sauce is phenomenal. I have just found a new camp favorite. Thanks to Jack. I think Jack and Stella's. That is phenomenal, man. Please give it a shot. I'm not sure if there are better chipotle sauces out there, but this one's really good. This is the President's Choice one from No Frills. That's too big. But I did it. That is awesome, man. Cook it in the bacon grease, add butter. The flavors are phenomenal. That's probably one of the tastiest things I've ever made right there. The chipotle sauce definitely has a nice little kick to it. Adding that extra spiciness to your morning. Especially if you slept on a cot all night. What a nice thing to wake up to here. Please let me know in the comments below if you give this a shot, because it is great. Just a little bit of goo in the middle. Now I know why they cook it in the oven and bake it, but this is way better than baking it, guys. Way better. Definitely slower, but totally worth it. My old man, what a good day. Zero sunshine, plenty of rain. Very, very gooey. But delicious. Yeah, it definitely would be great with a tomato on it, but doesn't need it. I never would have put chipotle sauce on a breakfast item. Now I'm going to, from now on, pretty much. Oh, everything's falling off. Scoop up some of that beautiful gooey slop. I have to wash dishes when I get home. I didn't bring any dishwashing soap. That's another thing I need to add. Umbrella dishwashing soap. That's how good it was. Time to clean up this mess and we'll go for a bike ride. Coffee first. I think I'm running out of fuel as well. I don't have a replacement. So I have it cranked and it's just giving me that little flame there. So I think I need to, I do have another one at home. I just didn't want to leave it in the car when the car gets really hot in the summertime. You know what I'm saying? Well, that's as hot as she's going to get. It's probably coffee hot, but not boiling hot. Yep, steam coming off it, which is good. Good old Rustool. All packed up, just gonna finish this. This time I'm gonna wear my rain pants and make sure that my legs don't get wet on this ride. I do have lots of clothing, so I can switch it up, but yesterday I didn't put my rain pants on, but this time I'm going to for sure.
Got my rain jacket on this time, my rain pants, because it is definitely raining now, so try to keep as dry as possible. Let's go. Here's another beach, no lifeguards, of course, but here's a boat launch. Somebody does have their boat in. It's nice that they have these docks and stuff for people to bring their boats, and then they can let them hang out for the whole time that they're here enjoying this beautiful, peaceful lake. It does look like there's other cottagers on this lake. It's not just a park lake. Beautiful area. Definitely want to bring my wife back when possibly we have a larger RV. Definitely steady rain now. I'm glad I put on my rain gear. Let's keep going. Burn some more calories. Go check out Stormy Lake since they're already wet.
This is Stormy Lake. A few boats, a few cars, a few trailers, not many. What a perfect day to visit Stormy Lake. A couple pontoon boats. There were a ton of boats over here. I believe you can rent these boats as well. There's a sign back there saying boat rentals. Look at this John boat thing. Oh, cool. You can put a four-wheeler on it and do a jump off the front. Very, very old boats. Canoe. This is the boat rental area for your paddle boards. Kayaks, again, a lot of canoes. Looks like people prefer canoes over kayaks. Oh, this is what I was looking for. Oh my goodness. That's exactly what I needed this morning. Oh well. Time to head back, drink some water, dry off. Made it back to Rusty. I definitely need to clean this van out, but I don't want to get it any messier than it already is. So I'm going to get my kettle, fill it with water, and then rinse off as much of the bike as I can. As you can see, it is very, very dirty. And I don't want to get even more dirt inside my van. So it's not as dirty as it was yesterday. Yesterday was really sandy.
guess because I took a different route. All right, let's clean up. Spick and span.
Little adventure I planned out for you. Well, almost kind of planned out for you. I've been thinking about doing this. Let's get that hat off for a second. That one's soaked. Put on a new hat. A dry hat. Put that up there to dry for later. All the way home, it's going to dry. Well, thank you very much, guys, for hanging out with me on this little adventure in Rasool Park in Ontario. Ontario Parks. And hope you try that recipe. And I hope one day, if you come up to Ontario, or if you live in Ontario, or if you live in the States and you want to go somewhere cool, Rasool looks like a really good place to hang out with the family or friends and enjoy it as much as I did. Like I said, when we were at the boat launch there, eventually we're going to be getting a larger vehicle so that my wife and I can start going on these adventures together. Right now, I'm just testing the waters, seeing how it goes just with this small minivan rig. And again, that's why I'm not spending a whole lot of money on the interior and building it out and putting drawers in and all that stuff, because I want to do all that for the next vehicle. And maybe we'll videotape all those, or all that process. All right, guys, once again, thank you very much for all your support. I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you. Bye.